The first step is to create a clay platform that we will use to embed half of the coin. Enough clay strips are cut to comfortably support the model and give sufficient wall thickness to the finished mold. The strips are put together and seams are joined and smoothed. A rolling pin is then used to level and smooth. A straight edge is used to create clean edges that will align nicely in the mold box. One half of the coin model is embedded in the clay, up to roughly the midpoint of the coin's side edge. The hex nuts are partially embedded and will serve as registration keys to lock half the finished mold to the other half. The mold box sidewalls are positioned and secured around the clay foundation using clamps. A glue gun is then used to seal the seams at the interface between the mold box sidewalls and the baseboard. The next step is to create a pouring vent that will allow us to pour a casting material into the finished mold, and an air vent that will allow air contained in the mold cavity to escape during casting. A small piece of plastic tubing is measured and cut. The pouring vent will extend from the mold box wall to the top of the model. One half of a piece of tubing is then embedded in the modeling clay. The vent is also embedded in the clay. The next step is to apply a release agent made especially for using with silicone rubber. Parts A and B of the silicone are measured out in equal amounts, dispensed into a mixing container, and mixed carefully. By the time you are done mixing, the rubber will be a uniform color with no streaks. The rubber is then poured in a slow, steady stream at the lowest point in the mold box and allowed to rise over and above the model. OOMOO rubber cures at room temperature. In about 6 hours, it is ready for demolding. The next step is to remove the clamps and mold box sidewalls. And the mold structure is then flipped over. The cured rubber, with the model still partially embedded, is now resting on the platform. The clay foundation is then removed, exposing the hex nuts and one half of the coin. The hex nuts are removed, leaving holes that are now the negative registration keys. The excess rubber is trimmed, taking care not to disturb the model. The mold box is then reassembled securely around the cured rubber with half the coin model still embedded. Hot melt glue is used to make sure that the liquid rubber will be contained. As before, OOMOO silicone is mixed carefully. The mixture is then poured over the first half of our mold. The rubber is allowed to cure at room temperature, and the mold box sidewalls are removed. The mold halves are then separated, and the model is removed to reveal the negative mold cavities that reflect perfect detail captured from both sides of the model. The mold halves are brought together and secured using the registration keys. Rubber bands will help hold everything in place and minimize leakage of liquid resin during casting. A small amount of SmoothCast 300 Part A and B is dispensed in equal amounts. To give the finished casting a little color, a couple of drops of So Strong Color Tint is pre-mixed with Part B. Parts A and B are then mixed thoroughly for about a minute. The mixture is then carefully poured into the pour vent. The mold is slightly rotated to displace air in the mold cavity. And more resin is added as needed. Because this is a small amount of material, the resin is allowed to cure for about 20 minutes. The rubber bands are then removed and the mold halves are pulled apart, revealing the casting. The mold has reproduced detail from both sides of the original perfectly.
Hallelujah.
Excess flashing is then removed with a razor knife. We now have an exact reproduction of our two-sided original.